Hello friends, and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we are going to cover cycle detection in an undirected graph using the union find algorithm. So first, we see disjoint set data structure. It is basically a data structure which helps us keep track of a set of elements partitioned into a number of disjoint subsets. So if we have n elements partitioned into subset, it will keep track of connectivity of each element in a particular subset and also connectivity of subset with each other. Here you can see the three sets we have. These are disjoint set as they have no elements in common. Or we can say that their intersection with each other is an empty set. So, this disjoint set supports two operations. The first is the union operation and the other one is find operation. So, if we apply these operations on these three sets, the union operation will join two subsets into a single subset. That is, union of S1 and S2 will give us a set containing elements of set S1 and elements of set S2. Here you can see how the two sets have merged into one. Next, we can use find operation to determine which subset a particular element is in. So, if we say find B, it will look into the universe of sets and give us S1. Similarly, find of D will again give us S1 and find of Z will give us S3. Now that we have seen how union and find works, let's see how we can use them to detect a cycle in an undirected graph. So, the idea that we are going to use is that for each unvisited edge, we make subsets using both the vertices of the edge. If both the vertices belong to the same subset, we say that we have found a cycle. Let's see how the pseudocode for this would look like. Here is the code for our idea. We visit all edges one by one. And for both the vertices of the edge, we use find operation to check which subset it belongs to. If they belong to the same subset, we say that a cycle has been detected. Else, we do a union of the sets they belong to. We'll try using this algorithm on a sample graph and see if it works. Here is our cyclic graph on which we will run this algorithm. So, we have these five nodes as shown, and also we have a parent array, the entries of which are initially fixed to -1. So, this parent array basically helps us connect the elements that belong to the same set. The working of this will be soon clear to you. Initial values of -1 here means that each element is the representative of its own set or root of its own tree. See this diagram. Here you can see how each element says that it represents its own set. So, in total we have these five different sets. Now recall the algorithm that we have seen previously. We start by visiting edges. Let's begin with this edge connecting node 0 and 1. We do find operation on node 0 and 1. So, find of 0 is 0, as 0 is representative of its own set, and find of 1 is 1 as 1 is representing its own set. Since both belong to different subsets, we do a union operation and merge both the subsets. Union of 0 and 1 would give us a set having both 0 and 1. Now here comes the use of parent array. If we make 1 as parent of 0, it can help us track both the element of the sets. So 1 is the parent of 0 and this set is represented by 1. We then take the next edge. Let's have this edge connecting node 0 and 2. We do find of 0 and find of 2, which comes out to be 1 and 2 respectively. See, why find of 0 is 1 is because it belongs to a set which is represented by 1. And find of 2 is 2 because it is represented by 2 itself. Now, since they belong to different subsets, we do a union operation on the two subsets. Union of 1 and 2 will look like this. Look at the parent array. 1 is the parent of 0, 2 is the parent of 1, and then 2 is given the task to represent this subset. Also, we have three subsets now. 1 having 0, 1 and 2 represented by 2, subset with 3 represented by 3, and subset 4 represented by 4 itself. So again we take an edge. We choose edge connecting 1 and 3. We do find of 1 and it gives 2. And find of 3 which gives 3. Since both belongs to different subsets, we do a union of the two sets. Union of 2 and 3 will be like this, and the merge set would be represented by 3. Also notice the change in parent array. Now we are only left with two subsets. Next, we take this edge connecting node 1 and 4. We do find of 1 and it gives 3, and find of 4 which gives 4. Since both belongs to different subsets, we do a union of the two sets. Union of 3 and 4 will be like this, and the merge set would now be represented by 4. We also make 4 the parent of the node 3. Now we are only left with a single set. We now choose this last edge connecting node 3 and 4. We do find of 3 and it gives 4. And find of 4 which gives 4. Since both 3 and 4 belong to the same set, we say that we have found a cycle, and with this we can stop our algorithm. Here we see the implementation of what we have discussed so far. This code on cycle detection in undirected graph has been taken from GeeksforGeeks. This is cycle function takes a graph as input. It creates a parent array and also initializes each entry to minus 1. Next, it takes each edge one by one and then do a find operation on the vertices connected by this edge. If find of both vertices come out to be the same, we return 1 or true, else we do union on both the sets to which they belong. Here we have an implementation of find and union operation. These are the general function and are used in various application of disjoint set. So now we wrap up this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestion, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.